Hi, this is Victor Gamow with Confluent, and welcome back to this course about Spring Boot and Spring Kafka and Confluent Cloud. In the lesson number one, we'll walk you through some of the ideas behind of this integration, Spring Kafka integration. Why would one want to use this, and what kind of things you can expect from this project? First of all, let me talk about why you want to use Spring. So first of all, Spring is a framework that provides some of the best practices in the modern application development. Even though Spring was around for the last, 15 years, still going strong and embraces some of the modern piece of technology. The current version of Spring Framework is version 5, supports modern version of Java, supports even cross-language things. There's integration with Kotlin. It is quite popular and a very big number of developers, Java developers, JVM developers use Spring these days. Spring Boot can simplify and reduce time that you spend in development and increase overall productivity because integration in some of the opinionated configurations that Spring Boot provides, it is huge help, especially when you starting with something. It's much better to follow some of the predefined and maybe opinionated ways. Some people call it magic. I call it just a well-crafted piece of engineering. So that's why I personally love to use some of the defaults that Spring Boot provides. However, Spring Boot provides the ways how we can extend and modify certain things if you need to customize or something. Some of the opinions that Spring provides will not fit with your own opinions or requirements of your system. As a modern framework, Spring embraces what's called two-factor application manifesto. Essentially, it allows to run your application and to change the configuration based on environments and move the same code between different environments without changing this code. In this case, Spring supports different profiles that allows you to provide different configuration parameters based on your environment. For example, if you're in development, you will use some of the development database connections, maybe even connection to some local host. If you're on QA on production environment, you definitely want to use different systems or different the connection to the system that will be very close to your production. Spring comes with a variety of the batteries included. Integration with databases, integration with messaging systems, integration with the APIs, you name it. So virtually any data source that you have in a modern application landscape will be able to interact with your Spring code. We're going to be focusing on the project called Spring Kafka, which is sole purpose is provide you opinionated way how you can be productive of writing your Spring Boot and Kafka applications. Spring Kafka project is a top level Spring project. You can find this in a Spring website, spring.io/project/Spring Kafka. The way how you can find documentation, get the latest artifacts and all the things you can find there. The goal of this project to bring the familiarities that the people already have with the Spring Boot framework or the Spring framework and the Spring Boot into world of Kafka developers. So for example, if people use in the past some integration with messaging systems like a JMS, people tend to use a thing called JMS template that allows you to publish messages into JMS queue. Spring Kafka comes with a similar pattern or similar class, similar set of APIs called Kafka template that allows you to send the messages to Kafka topic. And this is like a very foundational API, and it's essentially a very thin layer on top of the Kafka producer API that comes with this. However, it also brings some of the integration with Spring Boot. For example, the way how you can configure this, you can do this programmatically or can you do this declaratively using the property files. Many aspects that allows the people to write applications that will not depend on some of the intricacies or like communication between like underlying technologies, how the message will arrive from the message queue and how it will be passed into your code. So in this case, Spring provides with the two things. It provides you message listener container that allows Spring to handle some of the low-level communication stuff, including retries, including some of the serialization. And you will just focus on just the processing logic. That's how you're supposed to do. Not the plumbing, but rather than actually implementing business logic. Spring Kafka provides integration with Kafka listener. It's Kafka listener, it would be special annotation that you can annotate any POJO or method of the POJO, and this method will become your Kafka consumer. A lot of things that people want to do with Kafka is using admin API and manipulate with topic configuration. Also, Spring simplifies the way how you can define your topics. You just define a bin with type new topic and using topic builder to create the Kafka topic in a very nice and concise fashion. A very common question that I'm getting from the people all over internet is that should I use Spring or should I use just like a plain old API from Kafka and do not worry about any other frameworks. So it's always a question about your productivity and where you want to spend your time. So Spring already provides certain ways how you can configure your applications. Those ways are opinionated and they well defined. However, it's very easy to communicate this with other Spring developers, and it's important in the different teams. If you're working on some common project, you can easily explain how the things would be configured for your Kafka project, or you easily learn if you knew how you can do these things with Spring before. So in this case, it's always answer is, or choice is yours. Should you use a framework? Should you use Kafka? Should you use like Kafka APIs? My goal for this presentation is give you tools and explain how you can be productive with certain frameworks, and hopefully you will pick the right choice and find this information useful. Stick around for the next session that will include exercise showing you how you can speed up and start new Spring Boot project and connect it to Confluent Cloud. My name is Viktor Gamov, and as always, have a nice day.